Andy Borkowski here for VGS, continuing our Disco Elysium walkthrough. This is part four in a 500,000 part series, trying to figure out the mystery of the Hanged Man. In this part, I have my first debrief with Kim. I do something very questionable with my thumb, and I learn a little bit about cryptozoological animals. Please enjoy.
Can I help you? Thank you.
Just a moment. You had some questions earlier, I believe. And besides, we should discuss our progress on the investigation. Let's go out to the balcony. Where shall we begin? We should talk about the investigation, first and foremost. But I also remember you wanting to discuss the RCM.
Thank you. remember your wife's hand on your face. That's right, Funky Baby. And you just stood there. One hand on the bottle, and the other on your dick. Watching her go. Let it all be dragged away from you. Tell me, where are your friends? Human beings have friends, Harry boy. Where the hell are yours? No, it's gone. 3 times gone and never coming back. You failed. You failed me. You failed Elysium. Everything. The pale and the isolas on the surface. The outer magnetosphere. Burning, furious truth. 8,000 years of written history. You really dropped the ball, Harry. 4.6 billion people, and you failed every single one of them. You really fucked up. No, Harry. You were just talking to yourself. That's all you ever do. Even in your dreams, and the act is wearing thin. The spots on the disco ball fade around you. You'll be back in those cold snakeskins in no time, sweating up the bed.
Stinky boy.
You're not coming back from shit. Thrashing around in that high conductivity state of yours, bumping into things and acting like a clown? Who are you kidding? You're trying to what? I can't hear you. This is just a word dream now. Jumbled up garbage. The pictures are gone. The bed rises to meet you. A thin, sleep-like state. More glass than velvet, grinding in your head.
Something is wrong. Sleep shouldn't be this bad. This dry, this unnourishing. There's something wrong with your thoughts. Some kind of new type of hangover. Oh yes, party boy. And it's worse than the one before. Just think of the shit you saw. Here it comes too. So soon already, a silent alarm goes off in your head like clockwork. Barely let you sleep at all. Time to get those clothes on, Harry. Time to go to work in the shit factory.
Morning. Yes.
Can I help you? you.
Just a moment. And there's no public phones nearby.
The closest phone booth is down the coast. Sorry for the inconvenience, ma'am.
It's fine. I understand. Thank you anyway. I'm glad to see you again, dear. Please don't trouble yourself about me, sweetie. I was just hoping to make a call, but the Whirling's phone line isn't working. The union office probably has a phone, but I can't really get there. Or to the phone booth down the coast. And Gary's phone is dead too. The manager was vague about it. To let the young woman who is house-sitting for us know that we may be delayed. Morel, my husband, and Gary were supposed to be back on Monday night, but they're still missing and I haven't heard from them. I was also hoping she'd heard from Morel. That's just it. This isn't like him at all. He always plans his expeditions so carefully. But you have more important things to worry about.
Thank you.
Can I help you? Thank you.